Hi, today I'm going to show you how to easily and quickly fake that blowout look. And today we're going to be using a large barrel curling iron. This is Hot Tools Professional curling iron, and this is the 1.5 inch barrel. So it's a pretty large barrel. Here's a comparison of my hand to the barrel. I've purchased it because I wanted to curl my hair, like I actually have curls using this barrel, but it's actually a little bit too big for that, but it's perfect for getting those large curls that aren't actually that curly. They're more like body curls that you get when you're doing a blowout. So this is what we're going to be using today. You don't have to use this specific brand, even though I think it's the best curling iron brand, but you do need a large barrel curling iron because otherwise it's not going to work. 1.5 inch is probably the best size, especially if you have longer hair. We're also going to be using a heat protectant. This is what I typically use. I have to be honest, sometimes I don't use it because I'm too lazy, but I think it's a good idea to use it, so I do recommend that you do. This is Tresemme Thermal Creations. You don't have to use it, I guess. It's not going to like make your hair not look good, but it's always a good idea to protect your hair from extra heat. And by the way, I'm not using this curling iron on high heat. I'm against that because I think you can burn your hair pretty easily if you do that, especially on a daily basis. So my typical temperature that I set this curling iron to is like 300, 280 to 300, which isn't that little, but it's also not like 450, which some of them go to as far as 430, 460, something like that, which is really, really hot. Your hair will get burned like that. And it happened to me. I'm speaking from experience. We're also going to need a pin tail comb. This is not, again, not like a super necessary thing, but it's just nice to do a nice part. It's nice to be nice. It's nice to do a nice part in the middle, because if your hair is looking nice but your part's all like screwed up, it's just gonna mess up the whole look. And then we're gonna need two more things. This is a crocodile clip. I got this in the set of six. You're gonna need something to pin the top portion of your hair. You don't have to use a crocodile clip. You can use any other clip you have, but this is an awesome clip. Let me show you a quick preview of it. It's great. I love it. They're so, so versatile, and they can hold a large amount of hair by just doing this, and then you can take it off as well. And last but not least, we're gonna want something to make our hair look really shiny and smooth, and I'll be using Garnier Sleek and Shine Anti-Freeze Serum. This is like John Frieda Freeze Is kind of a product. If you have that, you can use that. If you have something similar to this, you can use that. I'm not really particularly like advertising this product specifically, but something like this would just make your hair look silky smooth and beautiful. So anyway, let me go ahead and get started. Let me take my comb and just give myself a part, because I like to do that kind of in the beginning. Then I'm gonna take the front, or the top section of my hair, and I'm gonna pin it up. Make sure it's nice and secure and looking rather funny. Next, I'm gonna take my heat protectant, and I'm just gonna give this side of my hair a nice spray. So I'm gonna take a fairly small section of my hair. If your hair is longer, I suggest, and especially like longer and thicker, I suggest taking smaller sections, only because what happens when you're curling your hair is you clamp the ends, right? And then the more you turn it, the less heat the top section of your hair gets. That's why when you're using curling iron, the bottom of your hair is a lot more curled than the top. But with such a large barrel, you're not gonna get a thick curl or like a curly curl anyway, but you do want to get some curl even here. Not curl, but some body. So just take a small section. It's just gonna work better. I should have just said that in the beginning, I guess. What you're going to want to do is clamp it and move your hair towards the bottom, and then just roll it up. And I like to roll this away from my face. I like that look. But you can, I guess, roll it any way you want. Let that sit for a little while and then release. And this is where you're going to be left with right away. But as you're doing the rest of your hair, this curl will get slightly undone. And then it's going to be less curled and more like a blowout look. So let me go ahead and do the next section. So this is the entire bottom of my hair done. As you can see, my hair has a lot more volume now. Not a lot more, but more than it typically would. And the ends of the hair are curled inside. That's because I was curling my hair this way, so I was curling it away from my face. That's how you get the ends to curl in like that. As you saw, it was really easy to do. And that being said, let me go ahead and do the top section of my hair. And what I like to do is I like to pull the section of the hair that I already curled back, so I know it's curled and it's finished and done with. And the section that I need to do, or the part of the hair that I need to do, moves to the front. I'm gonna do the same thing as I did on the bottom, but this time I like to take even maybe smaller sections, only because the top layer is the layer that you see more. So I just finished curling my hair slash giving myself a blowout, and the last thing you want to do, and I guess this is optional but it does look good if you do do this, is, as I mentioned before, use the Sleek and Shine Anti-Freeze Serum by Garnier or any other type of a product, and just focus mainly on the ends. This just makes your hair look well, less frizzy and shinier and softer feeling. So I love using this. Again, don't get too close to the roots here, because then your hair is gonna look really greasy. Do not do that. Just focus on the ends. So let me show you my hair now. This is what my hair looks like now. I'm mainly focusing on the ends because the ends are like the most important thing, I think, in the blowout, because that's where you really get to see the curl, the light curl that your blowout gives you, and then also the body that you will get throughout the hair as well. That really comes from the ends and how they curl and stuff. So I think it looks like a blowout, don't you? So I think this was pretty quick and easy. It typically takes me about 10 minutes or so to do this in the morning or in the evening when I'm going out. Not that I go out that often, but when I do, this is kind of my go-to look. It just looks so nice, I think, and it looks like you've done it, almost like you went out and got a blowout, I think. And again, the trick is to use a large barrel curling iron. Hot Tools is my favorite. I will leave the link to this curling iron down below. And also, another tip or trick is to use anti-freeze serum. This will make your hair feel like you just went and got it professionally blowed out. But yeah, so there's not much to it, but these are a couple tricks, and I think your hair will look really nice by the end of it. So with that, I want to say thank you so much for watching my video. If you want to see more of my video, subscribe down below, and if you did like this video, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you later. Bye.